Hello everyone, hi, welcome to the channel of Wall Street Mojo. Friends, today we're going to learn a topic, a concept that is on trailing PE versus forward PE. So what exactly is trailing PE? What exactly is the forward PE? That's what we are going to discuss over here. We'll start with the trailing PV. Okay. Now, trailing PE is where we use the historical earnings. Remember one thing, historical earning per share in the denominator. So you can say EPS and trailing PE per ratio. This basically the formula, you know, it's something such sort of, it's like this is equal to its price per share divided by the EPS over the previous 12 months. Okay, so let's take one trailing PE example and understand. Let's calculate the trailing PE of Amazon. See, Amazon's current share price, that is P0, is 1586.51 as on 20th March 2018. Okay. Now, let's say the earning per share past 1 year, okay, based on various quarters and all, let's say the EPS, TTM, which is known as for trailing PE, is let's say 4.576. okay, so in that scenario, what is going to be a trailing PE? Because this EPS is for your 12 months. Okay, so it's P0 divided by your EPS, that will give you 346.7x. and now that is a PE TTM. So this is your trailing PE. Now the next thing that we are going to discuss is the forward. What is the forward PE ratio? So the forward PE ratio is basically the price per share divided by the forecasted. It is your price per share divided by the forecasted EPS, right? Let's take another example for forward PE. Let's say the same current price is 1586.51. And let's say the EPS for the December 2018 and year ending December 19 is 8.31 and 15.39. So the forward PE ratio for 2018 is going to be your price divided by December 2018 EPS, that is the forward PE. And in case of December 19, it's going to be 103.08x. So what exactly is the difference between the trailing PE and the forward PE? And over here we'll write as the forward PE. So as you can, you know, note that, you know, the key difference between the two is the EPS that has been used. Now for trailing PE we use the historical EPS. What do we use? Historical EPS. Whereas for the forward PE we use the EPS that has been forecasted, right? Now, trailing PE versus forward PE example that we are going to take. See, trailing PE uses the historical EPS while the forward PE uses the forecasted EPS. Let's look at another example to calculate the trailing versus forward PE. Now, there's this company called 𝐖𝐡𝐴, which has the 12 months EPS of $10.10, and its current market price, that is P0, is $2.34. So the trailing 12 months EPS is going to be 234 price divided by earnings, that's 23.4x. Likewise, let's calculate the forward PE earning of AAA company A. Company A's AAA 2016, let's say estimated EPS is let's say $11, and the current price P0 is 234. So the forward PE earning ratio, the forward PE ratio formula is going to be 234 divided by the share price, that will give you 21.3x. Now, what are the important points that one needs to note while in interpreting or calculating trailing versus forward PE ratio? See, some of the things that you need to consider regarding trailing PE ratio versus forward PE ratio is that, you know, if the EPS is expected to grow, okay, then the forward PE ratio will be lower than the historical or the trailing PE, you can say, or the trailing PE ratio. Now, from the example that we learned, you know, there is an increase in the EPS, and you know, hence the forward PE ratio is lower than the trailing PE ratio. Second, on the other hand, if the EPS is expected to decrease, then you will note that the forward PE ratio, okay, will be higher or greater than the trailing PE ratio. Now, you need to note that the forward PE only forecast, the forward PE only forecast the EPS of 2016 or maybe, you know, 2017, whereas the stock price will reflect the earning growth prospects for far into the future state. So that's one big thing that you need to consider. Fourth, one should not only compare the trailing ratio for the valuation comparison between the two companies, but also look at the forward PE also. Forward PE ratio to focus on the relative value, whether the PE difference reflects the company's long-term growth prospects and the financial stability.